what's called level 3 assessor data from MassGIS. Anybody can download it. It's available on MassGIS. It was compiled in 2014, so SNAP was from fiscal year 2014 data. And all we did was join the assessor data table from 2014 using the use codes and use descriptions of all the lots in town, and we link them to the parcel geometry using GIS tools. That was the most complete set that was readily available that we could download. Obviously updated and asked to be produced later if we have access to newer data sets. From the map, you can see that 83% of the single-family homes in 2014 and 80% of the housing stock in Amesbury in 2014 were single-family homes, and 17% of the housing stock were non-single-family homes, including 9% were two-family, 1.5% three-family, and so on. To present a more detailed overview of the housing inventory, we included the number of housing units for each category in the map, and we did the percentage of housing units for each category, and also we calculated the acre, the square acreage of the total. Okay, so that's basically it. We also included the wetlands on the map so that you can see areas that were wetlands that obviously, you know, that are exempt from future development, and just wanted to show it. So that's basically it for the public.
Can we zoom in a bit on the downtown infra? I want to just highlight the detail that's on these maps too.
Right. And do you want to take questions at the end, or did you each?
Why don't we take them as they come, and then we can, but if you have big questions, if you want to hold them, we're going to have four other maps to show you, but please.
Just a basic about the percentages that you offered, were those are by, like, number of households, so when you say 83% of the?
83% of the total households.
Total households are in single family, 1.3 and 5 and 3 family, 9 and 2 family, and then the remainder in something other than.
Yeah,
there was. So the multi family
are about 17% of the housing stock.
Right, including 2 and 3.
Yep. Including 2 and 3. Some were larger buildings of unknown units, so they fall in the unknown category that was called unknown.
Unknown is 3?
Yeah.
Jesus. Thank you.
So, can you explain the symbology on the map?
Yes, the gray features that are on top of all of the lot lines are all the actual building footprints. Those were 2011 building footprint data that we also got from MassGIS to show where the buildings lay on the lots. The area with the white parcels is a non-residential area, so you can see how all the residential areas line up around the other. That looks like an older commercial or industrial area. So you can see all the residential parcels that are around it, and all the items are on.
Let's make it easy for you.
I'm sorry, someone asked this earlier, I came late, but what is the
want to have single family? I believe that the.
Single family.
Yeah.
Single family.
Yeah.
And what's the red?
Three family homes.
Yeah.
The dark red is eight.
Yeah, what's the dark red? The white is non-resident, is non-resident.
Or open space.
But like, when the farm is white.
I was gonna say, right, operating farms as well.
Yeah, it is, yeah, the operating farms would be in white too, it's anything that's open, yeah, anything that's not considered one of those residential categories.
We broke those out, so you'll see those in the other maps that show.